bit away from the noise. That's the guy, dude. Remember I followed? Yeah.
Live. I've been protesting with Armenians for almost 15 years now, and most protests that I've been a part of have been about justice. This is more important. This is about lives. I do not know what century Erdogan and Aliyev live in, but this is post-enlightenment America. And in democracy, life is always more valuable than land. Life is always more valuable than property. And our family and our friends are dying in Artsakh right now because Aliyev thinks that the land is more valuable than their lives, and he is wrong. And we will stay here until certain demands are met, and telling that story in the LA Times has a responsibility to get the facts correct and the numbers straight. Sadly, in the article that they wrote yesterday, some of the things in print are not correct. My family, me, Anthony, my Kalani Tsunami, you are not Islamophobics, and you're not white supremacists. No. We believe that all lives matter, and we are going to stay here until that story is told about the Armenian community and the Hasid that we all carry and share. In this context, emergency preparation and emergency response is part of what we owe the larger community of Segundo on this side and Los Angeles City on that side. We stand on the move. The Armenian people in Los Angeles, right here, they're getting the message. We are not going away until our demands are met. We have been negotiating with the mayor's office in El Segundo, and they have asked us to please be responsible to give one emergency lane on this side. And we're going to do that. In response, we said, well, then, you please put a police officer on each end to guard the emergency lane. And as we grow, we're going to ask that police officer and his car to move down another block. And since we go all the way to Long Beach this way, and all the way to Carlos Mathis.
Yeah!
We're going to keep growing and use it to We will continue to do this. As we continue with this protest, it's much more like a party. This is an Armenian family party. I just have four of us cooking in the street. At the last party we had over 40,000 people marching over 17 blocks over 2 days. When we finished, the police chief in Hollywood sent me a voicemail message and said, I don't know what I just experienced. It was incredible. You told me not to look too much, so please trust these people, and you were right. But that's not how he started. He started by saying, are you prepared to have 4 years arrested at the intersection? And I said, no. But if you have to arrest someone, you have to be first.
Yeah!
said, well, maybe we could stage it, make it look like an arrest, and make it easy. I said, we're going to stage this like a Hollywood movie.
This is crazy, like, how it's connected to, like, what we fully, like, watch.
And negotiated as community members with those police officers, hour by hour by hour. And in his message, when it was all over, he said, thank you for making the streets cleaner when you left than the streets were when you got there. In 48 minutes from the time we said, want to get shit? Gotta go home. John Cadella, time to see. We dispersed 40,000 people and 7,000 cars in 48 minutes. And when the big truck was still sitting there, there were tactics, workers, and workers still sleeping. And the police officers. Dog, could you please ask these ladies to stop sweeping? We need to open Sunset Boulevard. He said, I've never seen this before. He's giving me a call. I'm going to tell you this in person. God bless you. Taking pictures. I'll be back in a few minutes. Got a window. God bless you. Yes, you remember.